like and subscribe right now, or else this will be in your bed tonight. r/AskReddit by Reddit Universe. What conspiracy theories do you think are too logical to ignore? Denver Airport being a fallout shelter for the elite. The fact that it went like a billion over budget and all the symbolism. So my dad actually confirmed a popular Reddit conspiracy theory. I told him about the laundry detergent caps have the full line too high on purpose, and he told me this was true. He interned at P&G, and they taught him the full line was for the highest level of cleanliness our product can give. You can get away with using much less detergent. 1. Kennedy gets elected. 2. Kennedy is critical of the CIA, his own VP and military for wanting to turn the Cold War into a hot one and the willingness to perform false flag operations, Project Northwoods, to do it. 3. Kennedy is shot. 4. His VP takes power. 5. Classified. Pretty sure I saw it here on Reddit at one point, but someone brought up the art trade. That these million-dollar art shows, individual pieces that go for insanely high prices, are just a way for money laundering. David Miscavige, the chairman of the Church of Scientology, definitely murdered his wife and is getting off scot-free for it. Him and his wife got into a pretty heated argument in 2007, and she hasn't been seen since. Lawyers hired by David claim she is still alive and devotes 100% of her time to work at the Church of Scientology, which is why she hasn't been seen since August 2007. In 2013, a former member of the church had filed a missing person report that was closed after a few officers had spoken and seen Mrs. Miscavige, even though there's no evidence whatsoever of this meeting. All missing persons reports now are turned down since this investigation is forever closed. This one is small and local, but still too insane to ignore and just came up today. Just recently, our small suburban town's favorite gas station went out of business. Everyone went there. The guy who ran it was the mayor. He retires and sells the property after an issue with the ground underneath the gas pumps. They tear down the gas pumps and keep the garage. Mavis Tyre bought the property and opened a new store. A few days after the Mavis opens, someone posts a picture on Facebook of an intersection at a road near it with nails all over the road. The guy theorizes that a box of nails fell off of a construction truck. The police come clean it up and it seems all is well. Fast forward a few days later and people are commenting on the post that they're finding nails in their car tires. Not just from that intersection. People jokingly say maybe it was the new Mavis guys throwing nails around, but nothing really happens. Several weeks later, people have been posting day in and day out pictures of nails in their car tires. My dad took my car into the Mavis in question about 3 weeks ago and they found a nail inside of the right front tire. I noticed that it was driving sort of funny, but never that my tire was on the verge of exploding. I jokingly said people have been saying you guys have just been going around throwing nails all over the place, trying not to laugh at how insane it sounded to say out loud. The guy behind the counter said nothing, but yeah, with a weird smirk. Over 50 people have posted on the town Facebook that their cars have had nails in their tires. My mum is driving my car now, because her car has a nail in the tire. It's been almost 3 months. I'll post updates if anyone is interested. The Denver Airport theory. I mean, the capstone of the building literally has the Freemason logo on it, there's some weird ass apocalypse murals on the walls. The runways look like a swastika, and there's a 50-foot tall horse statue with red glowing eyes. I mean, seriously, who the frick designed that place? US intelligence conducting organized blackmail operations out of Epstein's island. The prosecutor handling Epstein's old case was told to back off and go easy, because Epstein was intelligence. Acosta's departure from the administration confirmed that this was not just a rumor. So as an American, I would really like to know exactly who was blackmailing who, how far it extended, and what political decisions were affected. Dr. Claw is Inspector Gadget. Some torture devices such as the Iron Maiden were made up hundreds of years later so people would think, well, a regular hangin' ain't too bad then. That bitch Debbie who used to work in accounting stole the succulent I had on my office desk. She always made comments about how much she loved it. Then she quit her job here. I come into work the next day and it's mysteriously nowhere to be found. Haven't seen it since. Trader Joe's makes their parking lot small intentionally to make it seem like it's more popular. Nutley, NJ, where Martha Stewart was born, has a butcher shop every other corner. How much meat does one small blue-collar town need? Suspicious. With all the scientists in the world, there has to be at least one secret lab on this planet where they have cloned a human. Let me introduce you to Wonka Pisser, the theory that Oscar-winning director Bong Joon-ho made a sequel to Charlie and the Chocolate Factory with his 2012 film Snowpiercer. That karma on Reddit really does nothing. My dog did not go to Doggy Disneyland because he won a lifetime ticket for being a good boy. I think that he in fact died. Our phones and, or the apps on them are listening to conversation. I'm super anti-conspiracy theory, but this has happened to me way too many times in the last 2 years. I impulse shop really badly. I carry cash for the explicit purpose of I can use this guilt-free for an impulse purchase. 2 years ago I bought high-end lipstick with cash in a store after doing zero research on the brand. Next day I had ads for it despite never even previously hearing of that company before. I had only talked with a sales associate about the brand for a while. 6 months later a very similar thing happened when I switched hair care products to very specific brand. Later that night I had ads for their company which I had never heard of or looked up pre or post purchase. 8 months ago I ordered a cider I had never heard of at a bar in NYC. Didn't research the company or anything about it. Not even 2 hours after I left the restaurant I had ads for that brand of cider on my Facebook. There's easily 5-7 more times I could think of, but these are the ones that bother me the most, because I am positive the transactions were all in cash. I had never looked up the product before, and I had very targeted specific ads from those exact companies less than a day later on most of my social media. I like that people always are worried that Epstein was murdered, instead of suicide. What if this was a ploy to cover up that he just escaped or paid his way out of prison? The FBI keeps posting questions like this to see what the public knows. Some people had to talk about Fight Club. Otherwise, it wouldn't exist. McDonald's shake machines are never actually down. The night crew people are just too lazy to clean it. Google Maps only asks you for feedback on its navigation when it knows it did a good job. I use navigation all the time, and I find that when it gets me to the destination on time or earlier than predicted, I get a notification asking to rate the trip. But if it gets me there after it originally estimated, I never get that notification. Mike Bloomberg is a ploy by YouTube to get us all to get YouTube Premium to stop seeing his ads. Jamie Lynn Spears was raped by Dan Schneider. He is the father of her first child. Oh, time to sort by controversial. The fashion industry makes too much money from purses to care about making pockets for women easily available. Jamie Lynn Spears, Miranda Cosgrove, Victoria Justice, etc. were raped by Dan Schneider. Nickelodeon let him get away with a lot. There's so many feet jokes in all those shows. A lot of the interviews with those cast members get really awkward when they're around Dan. If you got to pursue your dream career when you really wanted it, wouldn't you do just about anything? If you made Dan Schneider mad, your career would be ruined and your dreams would be over. The US government's involvement in the crack cocaine epidemic. Probably too late to this thread, but the idea that there are too many chicken wings for the amount of chickens sold. There is something like a billion chicken wings sold every Super Bowl. Where are they coming from? Pro tip. Read the comments in Alex Jones's voice before deciding whether to believe them. Typing in your email address to unsubscribe from a mailing list actually enters it into more mailing lists. For your information, the moon landings were real. In fact, there were 6 in total and it's not hard to achieve. NASCAR is fake. It's just Hot Wheels going around a track and all the sounds are made by one guy in a sound booth imitating what he thinks a race car would sound like. That the US knowingly left POWs behind in Vietnam. Amazon Go isn't about replacing cashiers, but about selling stock, receiving tax breaks for R&D and selling marketing analytics on the shoppers. This is why the stores are placed in financial districts and aren't open 24 hours or the weekend. Their camera system is backed up by employees watching you. Google, Amazon, Go Chicago. They're closed right now. The true conspiracies are right in front of our eyes. The extent of corporate control over the democratic process is no secret, but we're all too busy debating the moon landing, flat earthers and anti-vaxxers. I believe that the U.S. government has men in black that make people disappear if they know more than what's good for them. Secret societies definitely exist. New Coke was a way for Coca-Cola to switch from real sugar to corn syrup without people noticing. Switch to the new formula that everyone hates. Keep it for a while so that people demand the old one back. Then switch it back after enough time has passed that people wouldn't notice the relatively subtle change. This isn't a conspiracy theory, but I find any chance I can to say that dinosaurs definitely had feathers and deniers are just clinging to Spielberg's image of them. The NFL manipulates its games just enough in order to get the best product out of their season, because they are a business with billions of dollars on the line. With the number of billionaires that are psychopaths or similar, there must be a few super rich serial killers out there. By extension, there must be people making money supplying victims in the same way Epstein was supplying girls to the wealthy who wanted to scratch an itch. With the money, power and influence would come governments and intelligence agencies willing to overlook or cover up terrible actions for leverage. Nothing's actually happening in Area 51. The government just keep it so people will focus on it and ignore the shady stuff happening somewhere else. I quite like the missing cosmonauts theory. It's unlikely, but seems like it could have been possible. It boils down to the idea that Yuri Gagarin wasn't the first man in space. He was just the first man in space to survive the entire process. The theory that Epstein didn't kill himself. Memes aside, he could have probably exposed a lot more rich people for their sex crimes. They just bumped him off before he could do so. My favorite one is that UFOs are justice in the way distant future time traveling. We probably developed some sort of cloaking device so we never see them except for when it malfunctions. We don't know who killed Kennedy. Saturated fats and cholesterol aren't particularly bad for you, but a very politically aggressive and ethically deficient scientist named Ansel Keys staked his career on the idea that they were. Published studies with egregiously poor methodology. In his landmark 7 countries study, he specifically picked those countries which best supported his aims while ignoring those countries that didn't, and waged a very aggressive campaign to destroy the careers of detractors. Famously, Dr. John Yudkin, who wrote Pure, White and Deadly, a book on the dangers of dietary sugar. Today, scientific nutritional authorities continue to drag their feet on revising the conventional medical wisdom due to the erosion to their own authority that this would represent. Ansel Keys was more singularly responsible for obesity in the US than any other person. That this question is reposted every couple of weeks by them to see just how close the public is to figuring out their schemes. And that this response is reposted every time to throw you off our trail. The reason hot dogs and hot dog buns aren't packaged in the same amount is so customers always have too many buns or hot dogs, so they have to buy more. Hitler didn't die the way history says. Even if one UFO sighting is real, then that changes everything we know about the entire universe. There is a reason that information on UFOs is dripped through the media. The Nimitz Tic Tac is the snowflake on top of the ice cube on top of the tip of the iceberg in terms of extraterrestrial life reaching Earth. UFOs are the single largest documented unknown event in human history, and we have freaking cave drawings showing people in the sky coming down to Earth. Bob Lazar and Dr. Stephen Greer are the most well-known, but literally hundreds of military, political and aerospace personnel have come forward to talk and show evidence of life and technology from outside our planet. Marilyn Monroe's death was very convenient for the JFK clan. That Toby Flenderson is the Scranton Strangler. You actually can see John Cena. McDonald's trains their employees to forget your sauce when you order nuggets. This saves them billions every year. I saw once that the Titanic that sank wasn't actually the Titanic, but a very convoluted plan to cash out insurance from the damaged R.M.S. Olympic. And that the Titanic retired in April 1935 under the name of R.M.S. Olympic. Can't find the article one read it on, but it kinda makes sense. Had pictures of the hull and some signature features that made it very convincing. The government purposefully planted crack cocaine in black neighborhoods and highly criminalized it to take attention away from Vietnam. A North American primate, aka Bigfoot. Not saying he's still around, just maybe he existed. Mattress firm is a drug cartel or a money laundering company, or maybe they're laundering money for the drug cartels. I don't know, but whatever it is, they're up to no good. OJ Simpson is Khloe Kardashian's father. Rob Kardashian himself didn't want a DNA test done, because he knew he wasn't the father. And if you look at Khloe, you can easily tell she has some similarities to OJ. That civilizations have risen and fallen far earlier than we currently are aware. And that ancient civilizations were way more capable than we give them credit for. The whole aliens in Area 51 thing was to cover up the fact it's actually a military test facility. The gov would rather have alien BS about that place than have other governments steal or sell their weapons and tech to avoid another war. Pretty smart in my opinion. Princess Diana car crash wasn't accidental. I truly believe P. Philip hired someone to get rid of her and have a feeling that when him, Elizabeth and Charles die some very secret conversations, emails etc. will come out. Madeleine McCann was accidentally killed by her parents. I don't believe they intended to do it, but I do believe they covered it up, and once the press etc. arrived they seen an opportunity to make money out of the situation. I think the CIA is behind the JFK assassination. That here on Reddit we're living in a virtual prison for the mind. That the world is controlled by a select few ultra rich. Of course it is, because they are doing all the backdoor deals, making each other even more money. There is a giant money laundering cycle driven by the sale of paintings. It's just a piece of canvas with some paint on it. I may understand some people would be willing to buy paintings from the Renaissance, but modern art is definitely a huge money laundering instrument. Diana's death was not so accidental. Birds. The moon landing didn't happen, the moon is still in the sky, it hasn't landed, so it might be true. A lot of memes about recently released movies and TV shows, Bird Box and The Witcher are good examples, as they're both supplied by Netflix, are supplied by streaming services. That we're being listened to at all times. My phone hears me when I say hey Siri and activates Siri. Same with my Google Home. They'd have to be listening at all times to hear that, right? Also, Spotify did a deal where if you have Spotify Premium, you get a free Google Home. There are also deals on them frequently, which makes it seem as though they are trying to get them in as many households as possible. Sainsbury's taste the difference cheese. The Allies certainly knew about the Holocaust long before April, May 1945. They never just happened upon the camps as they were defeating Nazi Germany. This begs the question on why they never lifted a finger to stop the importations, destroy the rail lines to the camps, etc. But they never did, despite them knowing what was going on. Michael Jackson and some other celebrities aren't actually dead in that they live remotely without social media just to enjoy their retirement. I like the one where humans are actually extremely stupid and only exhibit intelligence as an emergent property of population size. One human 0.001 intelligent thoughts per day odd equals no dice. 6.8 billion 0.001 intelligent thoughts per day equals spaceships and guns. World Bank and media manipulation. Just common sense that those in power would do anything they can to stay in power. Believing that the elite have our best interest in mind is simply foolish. The media is manipulated by the government so they can teach us what to think, feel and believe. Fidel Castro being Canadian PM Justin Trudeau's father. The resemblance really is uncanny. He looks nothing like his supposed biological father, and when you see that the dates his mum was staying with the Castros in Cuba, everything really does line up. She also had numerous affairs rumors with people like Mick Jagger while she was married. She really had a history of getting around and partying at places like Studio 54, etc. The reason Disney came out with a movie called Frozen was so that when you googled Disney Frozen, you would get information about the movie and not websites talking about Walt Disney's body being frozen. The same goes for Disney on Ice. I went way deep reading this and I'm disappointed in you, Reddit. These conspiracy theories were weak as frick. That the CIA invented the term conspiracy theorist to make the common folk dismissive of shocking abuses of power. The entertainment industry is designed to whore out kids. Epstein didn't kill himself. That intelligent humans and advanced societies existed before the last ice age. The theory that there is more to COVID-19 than governments are prepared to admit. This is our fourth major coronavirus after SARS and MERS and swine flu. Not sure if that's a corona variant, but governments are treating it like it's a far more virulent plague with quarantines, evacuations and a panic level completely out of proportion for the apparent number of affected and deceased. Government's knowledge of space aliens for over 60 years and other anomalies they don't tell the public that would cause panic or fear. Robert Kardashian retook the bar exam after not practicing law 4 years just to join OJ Simpson's legal team. He was also seen taking a bag of OJ when he got off the plane. The theory goes that the bag contained evidence like the murder weapon or bloody clothes, and Kardashian joined the legal team so he couldn't be called to testify. I don't deserve these upvotes. The bag thing wouldn't have been protected by attorney-client privilege and Kardashian could still be called even if OJ's his client. The Democratic Party is systematically suppressing Bernie Sanders in favor of Biden and Bloomberg. You know damn well, same as I do, that Sony Paramount made that stunt with Sonic on purpose. That's by far the best commercial they could have gotten, which saved them Lord knows how much money. ISIS was created by the CIA. Snowpiercer is a sequel to Charlie in the Chocolate Factory. Avril Lavigne actually killed herself and the Avril Lavigne now is her double. 9/11 was allowed to happen so the government could go ahead with political agendas that would have been very unpopular otherwise. There were all kinds of advanced warnings that an attack was imminent, yet they were ignored. The attack allowed for the invasion and never-ending occupation of the Middle East, as well as the Patriot Act that allows for increased spying by the government, and was passed only about a month after 9/11. There's no Illuminati that controls the world with virgin sacrifices, or secret handshakes and shit. No, the way I see it, the truth is far more mundane. The richest 50-100 people on each continent or geographical area get together every so often and decide collectively and separately who does what where and when, which gov't will do such and such, and so on. Money makes the world go around. Stands to reason that wealth pulls the real strings in the world. I mean, I don't sit about and obsess about this. I have shit to do. But it wouldn't surprise me at all. Check out the Bilderberg group. Pigeons are surveillance drone placed by the government. I've never seen a baby pigeon. They just spawn out of nowhere. The Chuck E. Cheese pizza theory. It makes too much sense. They can deny it all they want. Pizza slices that don't match up. Makes no sense. That Trump and Hillary were friends, they had a pact to have Trump run as president, thinking that if he acts so crazy that Hill will get elected. Then their plan went to shit. That school is made for factory, industry workers. Schools were on the rise during the Industrial Revolution, and are still quite the same today. In school, you have to follow given directions, then do them. You also receive information, then throw it back up on a test. The anti-vaccine movement was actually started to kill off people stupid enough to not get inoculated against deadly disease, thus strengthening the gene pool. Epstein didn't kill himself. Every time something major happens around the world or in a specific country, coronavirus, Hong Kong protests, Epstein, bills get passed while the citizens are distracted. It's stupid that in 2020 people still believe that giraffes actually exist. When they shut down all air traffic on 11/9, they gave specific permission for a bunch of rich, royal Saudis to fly out of the US. I've never understood it, either in isolation or within the context of any of the other conspiracy theories around the 11th of September attacks. I do believe that pigs can fly, that ghosts can haunt your bed, that little Timmy didn't die, that Paul McCartney's dead. I do believe that people see the future in their dreams, that aliens abducted me, that jet fuel melts steel beams. That lizard people rule the earth, that rapture's coming soon, that Obama faked his place of birth, that Nixon faked the moon. I do believe the world is flat, that Spanish flu was planned, that Donald Trump's a Democrat, that Masons rule the land of tricks and treasons. Large and small of each you might conceive, you'll find there's not a thing at Ali don't, in fact, believe. Lem just say it. The meteorite that wiped out the dinosaurs could be a UFO. And where are the aliens? It's pretty logical to alien believers. And it's just my favorite. Just thought I'd say it. Everything is just a long dream. And death is your body rejecting waking up, as it's gotten too used to being asleep. The Flat Earth Society was started by NASA to distract us from the fact that the Earth isn't flat or round. McDonald's puts chemicals in their paper cups to make drinks hit different. Courtney Love killed Kurt Cobain. My mom's answer was aliens, mostly because of the pyramids and the fact that there's no damn way we aren't alone even in the Milky Way. I say, as crazy as it is, the whole health conspiracy thing. Not because I'm an anti-vax, I believe wholeheartedly in medicine. But the reason is Americans are so sick all the time is because of the shit in our food. Half the preservatives we eat daily are banned in other countries where the health rate is so much better. I know I'm allergic to food dye, and I can't even use a lot of soaps, because they have that dye in it. I believe we would be a whole lot healthier if we banned this stuff and started making laws banning certain types of foods. There will never be a cure to cancer, because treatment's too profitable. I hear this one a lot, but it does make a bit of sense. Chemotherapy, radiation therapy, and all other cancer treatments are extremely expensive. And if a cure was developed, it would be just as expensive. But, I don't believe doctors are hiding a cure from the public health. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos every day.